Hi everyone, in this video we'll talk about accessible headings. We'll start with a brief introduction and then look at two websites to see a good example of headings and a website that could be improved. During these examples, we'll use the free Wave extension tool to see the heading structure and any issues. Check out our headings article below to learn how to fix inaccessible headings. Let's get started. Everyone uses headings to quickly see what a web page is about. For example, on this university's department page, I can use the headings to quickly find an overview of the technical writing degree, careers this degree could lead to, and different ways to get involved during my studies. Just like visual users scan headings to quickly navigate a page, users with visual disabilities use headings to find and navigate content too. In fact, when it comes to headings and accessibility, headings are the most used way screen reader users navigate a web page. That's why a clear heading hierarchy is so important. Let's take a look at how a screen reader would navigate a web page with a good heading hierarchy. I'm going to use Mac's VoiceOver screen reader to pull up the heading list and then navigate to some headings.
Headings menu. You are currently in the VoiceOver menu. The heading level 1, technical communication and rhetoric. Heading level 2, overview. Heading level 2, career application. Heading level 2, get involved. Heading level 3, link, undergraduate research. Heading level 3, link, undergraduate research. You are currently on a heading level 3, inside of the article.
Notice how this page's heading 1 immediately let me know what the content would be about. Then there were heading 2s that split up the main ideas and even heading 3s that got a little more specific. This made it easier to find information. Now we'll use the free Wave extension tool so we can easily see the heading structure. Check out the resources below for a link to download this tool. I'll start by clicking the extension, which will activate Wave. I can see a summary of all the accessibility results, but I'm only interested in the heading structure right now. So first, I'll jump over to the Structure tab. Here is where I can see every HTML structural element, including headers, navigations, main content area with headings, and the footer. I'll scroll down to the main content area so we can see the heading structure for the page's content. Right here, I can easily see what's a heading 1, 2, 3, and so on. Now let's look at a website that has a heading structure that could be improved. I'll pull up the heading list and scroll through some of the headings.
Headings menu. You are currently in the VoiceOver menu. This is a list of VoiceOver. Heading level 4, we believe in. Heading level 2, sunshine and joy in every detail. Heading level 4, try it on at home. Heading level 2, your personal dressing room.
This website doesn't have a heading 1 at the top, so right off the bat, I don't get context about where I am. From there, it's clear the headings are used for body text instead of organizing the content, which makes it hard to understand how the content is organized and where I want to navigate to. Let's use the Wave tool again to look at this website's heading structure. I'll click the extension and then select the Structure tab. Just like we saw in the screen reader's heading list, we can see the heading structure here as well. Let's look at some of the heading alerts by going to the Details tab. I've unchecked some of the other accessibility results so we can focus on the heading issues. Under Alerts, there are skipped level headings and possible headings. I can select the alert icon and it will take me right where the issue is on the page. Now I can select the icon on the page and then reference. This will give me information in my Wave tool about what the issue is and how to fix it. I'm going to go back to my Details tab now. We didn't have a heading 1, so I expected to see that alert here as well. I'm going to go back to my Structure tab and scroll down to see if there is a heading 1 somewhere else on the page. There are a few at the bottom of the page, which isn't how heading 1s should be used. This is why using the Structure and Details tab together is helpful. Just because the issue isn't showing in the Details tab doesn't mean there isn't a problem. Now that I've found these issues, I can go into my CMS editor or HTML to fix them. If you want to learn more about how to fix inaccessible headings, check out our headings article in the resources below.